Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about the diffusion current and what is the formula for diffusion current density and what is the total current density in semiconductors. Okay, so in the previous discussion we have seen about the drift current. Okay, so there we have derived the first the equation of current density for a conductor, and we have extended that to the semiconductors. Okay, because in conductors the carriers are only electrons, but in semiconductors the carriers are holes and electrons. That's why the drift current will be both due to the hole and at the same time the electron. Okay, similarly here also the diffusion current is also due to both holes and electrons. Okay, in the semiconductors. So we are going to see now about the diffusion current and diffusion current density derivation. Okay, so now before going to that, what is diffusion? Okay, so diffusion is due to the concentration gradient or non-uniform carrier concentration in a material or in a semiconductor. Because of that, the electrons or the charge carriers will flow from higher concentration region to the lower concentration region. So this process is called as what? The diffusion process. Okay, so here what is the diffusion? Suppose I will take here an n-type material and at the same time p-type material. Okay, so here I am taking an n-type material. Generally the n-type material or n-type semiconductor consists of majority carriers or electrons. Okay, out of that, here I am taking a material or a cell-type n-type semiconductor that consists of at one point more number of electrons is there, and at another point or another end of the material I have less number of electrons. Okay, so here we can say that there will be a non-uniform concentration of the electrons in this n-type material. Okay, so if you observe here this diagram, here more electrons will be there at this point and less electrons will be there at this point. So this region is called as higher concentration region of electrons, and this region is called as lower concentration of the lower region of electrons. Okay, so this one is higher concentration and this one is lower concentration. When if there is this point is there, that means at one point higher concentration is there and at another point less concentration is there for the electrons, then we can say that there is a non-uniformity that is present in the concentration of the electrons in the n-type material. Okay, if there is a non-uniform concentration in the material, then automatically the electrons will flow from higher concentration region to the lower concentration region. Okay, but here I have used another term, that is there is an existence of concentration gradient. So what is the concentration gradient means? Okay, the concentration gradient is the rate of change of carrier concentration with respect to the distance. Okay, that means what? If there is a difference in the carrier concentration with respect to the distance, that is called as concentration gradient. So here we can use both the terms. There is a non-uniformity in the concentration of the electron or charge carriers, or if there is an existence of concentration gradient in a semiconductor, then there is a process takes place. The process is called as what? Diffusion process. So here if there is a concentration gradient, the carriers will flow from higher region of concentration to the lower region of concentration. This process is called as what? The diffusion process. Okay, so here you can observe the clearly that is this one is of n type. Here it consists of majority or electrons that are present in this region, and there is a less number of electrons will be present here. So if I draw the graph with respect to the distance, as I taken from x equal to 0 to x, so as I goes on x axis I am taking the distance, on y-axis, I am taking the concentration of the electron with respect to the distance. Then if I draw this, so here we have up to this point, suppose if I consider x equal to 0 here and x equal to capital X, so at the somewhere at this point, that is if I consider x is equal to x1, okay, so at this point, before x equal to x1, less number of electrons will be there, and after x equal to x1, so there is a more number of electrons will be present. Okay, so if I draw the graph between this electron's concentration and the distance, so the graph will be obtained like this. So here, this one I am taking as x is equal to x1 and x is equal to 0. So as I'm moving from x equal to 0 to x equal to x1, there is a less number of electrons. That's why I have drawn the graph like this. And as I move away from x equal to x1, then here we have more number of electrons are present here. So that's why the graph is like this. Okay. So this represents this graph from x equal to x1 to x represents the higher concentration region, and before this x equal to x1, so we have the lower concentration region of electrons. That means what? Here the variation that is present in the concentration of electrons or the charge carriers with respect to the distance. That's why we can say that by seeing this diagram, we can say that there is an existence of concentration gradient. So that is the what the term concentration gradient. So I already defined that what is diffusion. If the concentration gradient is there, so the electrons will flow from higher concentration to the lower concentration. So I am taking here this one. So you can observe the arrow mark. The electrons will diffuse from higher region of concentration to the lower region of carrier concentration or the electron concentration here. So that what I am representing here, this one is the higher concentration region, and from that one the electrons are moving from higher concentration to lower concentration. So that's arrow mark indicates that there is a diffusion process will take place. Okay, so because of concentration gradient or the non-uniformity of electron concentration. So here the electrons will diffuse from higher concentration to the lower concentration, that is represented with the arrow mark here. Okay, and at the same time some current density will be developed, or if there is a flow of electrons, automatically we consider some current will produce. Okay, so that current, or we can say current density, we will consider here. The current density is opposite to the flow of electrons. Generally, we will consider if the electrons are moving this side, the current direction we will consider as opposite direction. Okay, so that's why Jn is nothing but the current density due to the diffusion of the electrons. The direction I am showing this side, and the electrons are moving from x to x equal to 0. Okay, so this is the direction of the diffusion of electrons here. The same diagram I have considered for the p-type. Okay, so if you consider here in the p-type, the majority are holes. But in our conductor, that is in the p-type semiconductor, we have at this region more number of holes will be there. In this region, less number of holes will be there. Because of this, we can say that there is an existence of non-uniform concentration of holes, and we can draw the graph between the number of holes or hole concentration with respect to the distance. Same what we consider for the electrons. So if I consider this one is x equal to 0, and this one is x is equal to x1, and this is x here. As we move with x equal to 0 to x, the concentration of holes will be increasing. So from x equal to x1, suppose here also I am taking that x is equal to x1 here, up to this point the hole concentration is very less. After this x equal to x1, we have observed that here we can observe that the more number of holes will be present. That's why the graph is increases exponentially here. I am showing here exponentially. Okay, so that is the carrier concentration or the hole concentration here after x equal to x1 increases. So we can clearly observe that here we have the lower concentration region of holes, and here we have the higher concentration region of holes. Okay, Therefore, we can say that there is an existence of concentration gradient. Okay, if there is an existence of concentration gradient, automatically the diffusion of carriers will take place from higher concentration to the lower concentration. So, this higher concentration is there, from this one, the holes will be diffused to the lower concentration region. Because of that also, some current will produce. That current, we are representing here as current density. Okay, so Jp here represents the current density due to the diffusion of holes from higher concentration to the lower concentration. Okay, so this is about how the diffusion process will be takes place, and what is the diffusion current, and what is the diffusion direction, and what is the diffusion current density direction in both n-type material and at the same time p-type semiconductor. So this is about the introduction of diffusion process, both in semiconductors, that is n-type semiconductor, and at the same time p-type semiconductor. Now we are going to derive the equation for the current density due to the holes diffusion, and at the same time the current density due to the electron diffusion. Okay, so here for that I am using here Flick's law. Okay, so what is the Flick's law here? So a flux of Fn will be produced as the electron diffuse from higher concentration to lower concentration, and that is proportional with the concentration gradient, that is dn by dx. Okay, so that is here the Flick's law what we are going to use. Okay, so the flux fn means here the suffix indicates what, f indicates the flux due to the electron diffusion, so n indicates that is electron diffusion. Okay, f is nothing but the flux produced and n is the electron diffusion, it indicates. Okay, so here the flux Fn of electrons due to the diffusion process is directly proportional to the concentration gradient. So what I consider the concentration gradient means the variation of carrier concentration with respect to the distance is called as what? The concentration gradient. So that is generally we will represent for the electrons, it is dn by dx. For the holes, we will represent as dp by dx. So the concentration gradient term for the electrons is dn by dx, and for the holes is we are representing with dp by dx. Okay, so now what is Flick's law here? The flux that is generated due to the diffusion of electrons is directly proportional with the dn by dx, or we can also call concentration gradient of electrons. Okay, so therefore we can write here Fn, that is the flux due to the diffusion of electrons, is directly proportional with the concentration gradient of electrons. So what is the concentration gradient of electrons? That is dn by dx. So therefore Fn is directly proportional to dn by dx. So here I am removing this proportionality and I am introducing a proportionality constant as dn. Okay, so therefore Fn is equal to minus dn by dx. So why, what is this dn? Dn is here, we have, that is nothing but the diffusion. Here dn is the diffusion coefficient of electrons. So that suffix n indicates what? The electrons, and d is nothing but the diffusion coefficient. Okay, so here I am removing this proportionality constant and I am introducing this diffusion coefficient of the electron. That is therefore Fn is equal to minus dn by dx. Okay, now I have to define what is the current density due to the diffusion of electrons. So here the current density I am taking as Jn diffusion. J represents the current density, n represents the electrons and diffusion. Okay, Jn diffusion is the current density due to the diffusion of the electrons. So that is equal to minus Q Fn. Okay, minus Q Fn. Here Fn is already we have defined. that is equal to minus dn dn by dx. Okay, so if we substitute this Fn value, so that becomes what? Minus q minus of dn dn by dx. Okay, why here you may get the doubt. Okay, why you are using here a minus q? Okay, so here we are considering the diffusion of the electrons. Diffusion of electrons we are considering. Electrons are means it is a negative charge. That's why the charge of the electron we are considering here is minus q. Okay, so to define the diffusion, current density of the electrons is equal to minus q multiply with the flux due to the diffusion of the electrons, that is Fn. Okay, so here if you substitute Fn value, that is minus dn dn by dx, so you will get minus q minus dn dn by dx. So minus of minus will cancel and that becomes plus, and therefore we have the diffusion current density of the electrons. Jn diffusion is equal to q dn dn by dx. So this is what the diffusion current density of the electrons. Okay, now we are going to extend the same theory for the holes diffusion current density. Okay, so here the diffusion current density of holes, I am writing here Jp diffusion. Okay, here previously what we consider for the electrons diffusion current density, we are representing the suffix n, n represents the electrons, but we have to extend that one to the holes because the semiconductor consists of two carriers, that is holes and electrons. So we have calculated the diffusion current density of the electrons. Now we are going to extend the same process for the diffusion current density of holes calculation. Okay, so here Jp diffusion I am taking as the diffusion current density of the holes. Okay, so therefore I am writing here similarly what we have considered. Jp diffusion is equal to, I can modify this one as QFP. Okay, so I can write here Jp is equal to, we can also write QFP. Okay, so here FP is equal to, what we can write is dP minus dP dP by dx. Okay, so the flux due to the holes diffusion is equal to minus dP dP by dx. This dP, this one suffix P indicates the holes diffusion, and dP here is nothing but the diffusion coefficient of the holes. Here what is dP here? The diffusion coefficient of the holes. Therefore we can write, or if you substitute in place of FP the value, that is minus dP dP by dx, so we will get Jp diffusion is equal to Q minus dP dP by dx. Now you can also get the doubt here why we are using plus Q instead of minus Q, because here we are calculating the holes diffusion current density. That's why the holes means it is of positive charge. That's why we are using the charge of the holes as Q. Okay, Q is the Q and minus dP and dP by dx. dP by dx is nothing but the concentration gradient of the holes, or the variation of the hole concentration with respect to the distance, we will consider as dP by dx. So therefore here if we take here, minus and plus will be there, so that will be minus. So the Jp diffusion is equal to minus Q dP dP by dx. What is dP here? The diffusion coefficient of holes. Okay, so now we got both the current density for the diffusion of the electrons, and at the same time the current density due to the diffusion of the holes. This Jp diffusion will give us the current density due to the diffusion of the holes. Okay, but we have to calculate in the total semiconductor, we have to calculate both the diffusion current density of the holes and at the same time diffusion current density of the electrons. The total diffusion current density, if I consider as J diffusion, that is equal to what you will get? The sum of Jn diffusion plus Jp diffusion. That is nothing but the diffusion current density of electrons plus the diffusion current density of holes will give us the total diffusion current density in a semiconductor. So that's what I am representing here. The J diffusion is equal to Jn diffusion plus Jp diffusion. We already calculated the Jn diffusion and Jp diffusion, just the substitution is there. Okay, so Jn diffusion we got is nothing but Q dN dN by dx, and Jp diffusion we got is minus Q dP dP by dx. Okay, so we can substitute the same value here. The J diffusion is equal to Q dN dN by dx minus Q dP dP by dx. Okay, so this is the total diffusion. Okay, right? But in our semiconductors, we have two types of current. One is drift current and another one is diffusion current. Okay, in the previous class, we have calculated the drift current density equation, and now we are having here the diffusion current density. Okay, the total diffusion current density and at the same time total drift current density we have calculated. Therefore, the current density in a semiconductor is equal to the drift current density. Previously, what we have calculated is N mu N plus P mu P EQ. This is the total drift current and this one is the total diffusion current. But what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the total current density in the semiconductor. That is equal to the current density due to the drift process and at the same time the current density due to the diffusion process. Okay. So here the drift current density we got this one. The total current density J in semiconductor is equal to the J drift plus J diffusion. Okay. So J is equal to J drift plus J diffusion. We already have the J drift, that is equal to N mu N plus P mu P into EQ. Okay. So that is I am substituting here, and at the same time just now we have calculated the diffusion current density in semiconductor is Q dN dN by dx minus Q dP dP by dx. The same value I am substituting here so that we will get the total current density in a semiconductor. Okay. Suppose this is what how you can calculate and what is the equation of total current density in a semiconductor. Okay. Right. So now suppose I want the current due to the drift of electrons or diffusion of electrons. How we can write it? We have calculated Jn as Jn drift as drift is equal to Q dN dN by dx. Okay. Now what I have to calculate here? Okay, for the given values of these things, they will ask you that calculate the current, drift current due to the electron drift, or due to the electron, diffusion, Jn diffusion. So they will ask you that calculate the current due to the diffusion of electrons. So I will represent that one, current due to the diffusion of electrons. That is equal to Jn. So we know that the current density J is equal to I by A, the current for unit area. So J is equal to, here we know that the current density, J is equal to I by A, that is the current for unit area, So we can represent here current for unit area. So similarly the same equation I can extend for here. Jn diffusion we know that Jn diffusion is equal to In diffusion, the current due to the diffusion of electrons by area of cross section of the material A. So that is equal to Q dN dN by dx. So what we have to calculate here? we have to calculate IN diffusion, that is the current due to the diffusion. So therefore I am taking this A to this side, so that it will becomes AQ dN dN by dx. Okay, so this is what current due to the diffusion, current due to the diffusion of electrons, diffusion of electrons. Okay, that is equal to, I am representing with IN diffusion, this is equal to AQ dN dN by dx. Okay, so this one is very important equation, because we are going to use this one in the coming, that means in the PN junction diode current equation. While deriving the current equation, we are going to consider this one, this diffusion current equation. Okay, that's why I am telling here itself. Okay, so this is about the calculation of the currents in a semiconductor, and at the same time the calculation of the drift current density, and at the same time diffusion current density and the total current density in a semiconductor. Okay, thank you.